Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. Now, we've got a new little range by Tesco's, being brewed up by Marsden's Emma Gilliland. That's her there. That's not her there, not there. I've seen that before, it looks like obscene thing. That is Emma Gilliland's thing there. Master Brewer at, is it Jennings or Marsden's? I think it's Marsden's. And I think she's been so for about a year or so, something like that. I could be wrong. Let me know if I am. But and it is a big but. Not Emma's. Not Emma's big butt, but it is a big butt. We're not here to praise the brewers or the brewery, because we haven't got a brewery listed on here. We've just got this brewed for Tesco's. There's no list of a brewery on here. There's not even anything on the bottle. So I just got to go by what's in it, and it says Simply. So that's some Tesco Simply range. I love the colour of the very majestic purple. Can you see that in the light there? Not picking it up very well here, I think. But a very majestic purple crown. Quite plain and lovely. The livery on here is very plain as well. You know, kind of just dark ale. Not even a name, Simply Dark Ale. It's kind of proposing to be kind of simply as if it's like value stuff. No, it might be valuable, value kind of thing if the quality's very high. The other one I had, that one, the quality was very high. It was lovely. I can't remember what I paid. Ah, got a receipt here. What have I got? Doesn't say, I don't think. No, that's an old receipt, that's why. Right, I ain't gonna look for all this. I've got me little bags of beer here. Right, let's get on with it. Simply Dark Ale. I'm jabbering on as usual. Turn that bus round. Now, it looks like it's pouring. Oh, a lovely coppery gold, bronze almost. Beautiful colour. I always get a little bit suspicious. I think Wells and Young's have really tainted me, because whenever I see a nice head like this and all that's copper colour and that, I start thinking of E405s and E150Cs and things. That is beautiful, that's such a beautiful colour. But you know, when you get these colourings, it means for nothing. I can't really show you that. And the kids have been playing with my bloody torches and things again. You can't leave anything anywhere, can you? No, he's going, oh, let's get that out there. Oh, here we go. Whoa. Right. We're going to have a... Here we go, 1 minute. Get the colour right for you. That's what you're getting. That's all colouring. Right. Smell nice straight away. You're getting kind of sugary molasses, muscovado sugar, tiny bit of cloves on there as well. Oh, that smells lovely. It reminds me a little bit of kind of a speckled hen or something on it. God, that smells glorious. Oh, what's that? There's something else in there, like a little bit spicy almost. What's that? It's nice. Right, it's down a bit. Chin, lads. Lads and lassies, even. Oh, I'm such a male show, but it's not. Right. Bottoms up. Up your bottoms. Oh. That's not bad. That's not bad. It's got something kind of that false carbonated that carbonic sort of thing going on. But, and it's something like a, I don't know, maybe a Fuggles or something that's been a bit overdone. It's kind of a little bit harsh and, you know. Funny enough though, as it goes down, it's clawing at the back of the throat, hanging on. It's hanging on for all it's worth and going, you still want to taste me. Yeah, there is, there's cloves there, there's star anise, there's, there's a little bit of dried fruit of some sort, but not the usual dried fruit, and occasionally you get dried strawberries when you've not got the usual dried fruit, you seem to get a dried strawberry float under, but this is like a dried cherry or something like that. Pardon me. Always pick up on your burp as well, because the beers kind of warm up in your stomach. Something slightly sherbety. And wood licorice, the little woody licorice, that's in there. It's not quite around the, I don't know if it's quite in the old speckled in thing, but it's heading around that area. It's almost like it's trying to copy an old speckled in. I'd love to try these side by side. It is different, and I don't think it's trying to be a copy, but it's almost, you know, it's almost heading in that, it's almost as if the brewer had, the brewer kind of, she had that stuck in her mind, had had that the night before sort of thing, and it was sitting in there subliminally. Cool, you try saying that. Subliminally. Yeah, as if it had been stuck in there subliminally. And kind of come out in the recipe sort of thing. It's not quite a copy, but it's heading in that direction. And it is nice. It's really nice. I can't remember how much these are. I will put a little link over there. That's how much they are. If I remember to do that while I'm editing the video. But, that's nice. That's nice. Would I say go and buy it and try it? Yeah. Buy it and try it. Buy it and try it. And do us a favour. You guys and girls there with all the flavour tasty buds and things, I always think it's good to have more than one opinion of something. So my opinion's worth nothing without you guys, you know. I'm just trying to guide you in the right direction when you're going out shopping and things, and kind of sometimes help you along with different little notes and different hints and tips. The few that I know, you know, I'm not Mr. Guru, and anyone that claims to be is an arsehole in, but anyone that claims to be is a bit of a bum thing, a bum hole or something. Did I get away with it? But no, anyone that claims to be a guru and all that. But I try to just impart my little bit of knowledge as far as I can, and I soak knowledge up from you guys as well. So, guys, try this alongside of, a speckled hen or something like that. Let me know what you think. Let me know if they're similar. And let me know which you think is best. I'm going to try these side by side, I think. I think I'm going to go down the shop, try them on the review side by side. Anyway, guys, girls, chin chin. Thank you very much, bombs up. Cheers.